Well, it's been a while, guys. How's it going? So, it's been a month or two, maybe. A lot of stuff happened. I've been saving monies for things. I was gonna buy property. And then the blue truck blew up. I sold that. I decided to do some things and buy something fun to take to events and maybe sling around some corners. So I purchased this, and the intent is to basically make it a drift car. I'm gonna do an angle kit, weld the diff, get a hydro, and we'll see where it goes from there. But I'm financially so far into the drift truck, which is still a part, and I don't want to ruin it. So I bought something I can go to events and actually participate and slide around in tandem and do things with and not be scared to ruin a 90s rust-free mini truck. And I did a lot of research, and just entry level, this is about the best bang for the buck you can to go slide some corners other than a Miata. But Miatas are just not my gig, not my thing. Sorry, Sean, if you're watching this. I know you're a Miata guy. But so today I got some wicked alignment issue. I'm gonna see if anything's bent or broke. If not, I'm gonna take it in for an alignment, put it on the stock wheels, and then I'm gonna buy some tires for these new wheels I got from Graduus. He printed me out some decals, so shout out to Graduus for my banner. This is a 2003 Nissan 350Z. It's got a 3.5 liter NA VQ. Apparently it's a DE or some crap. I don't know. I don't know anything about them, really. So I got a big learning curve. But I'm gonna do my research and look into things, and I think it's gonna be a pretty fun piece of machinery when I get there. Eric's here. Eric! Cool sandwiches, bro! I think Evan's over here.
Evan!
Oh, that's not appropriate. But yeah, so should be fun. So I'm gonna get under it. I've done plugs, I've done an oil change, bought a couple things for it, but yeah. These guys are ripping stuff apart for me, so that's cool, but we gotta get to the yaw sensor to take that out and basically make so many driver safety assists, the ABS, the yaw and pitch sensor, which turns on slip, which pulls your throttle. If you lose traction, you lose throttle response. So as soon as you start sliding and all these things freak out, the car loses power and it tries to straighten itself out. Unlike its predecessor of the 240, which you hit the gas, you go, slide, it didn't matter. You did what you wanted and it went where you wanted it to. So there's a couple mods that you can do. You can unplug it. You can cut your pins in your ABS fuse, because it's combined with the ignition. You can't just pull the fuse. You gotta rig something up or snip it. But I am gonna go under the fuse box to the power supply and put it on a toggle switch along with the yaw and pitch sensor, so that I can turn them off while at events, have a bunch of Christmas lights on your dash, because the car don't like it when it can't communicate with its safety sensors. And then I can turn them on, lose the lights on the dash when I drive it on the road, which I'll probably still have it off then, but we won't talk about that. But That's what we're gonna do today. So, you guys are awesome for hanging in there. That's still on the back burner probably for next year. And the drip truck, I am gonna have running this summer, but not to the extent that we were going. I'm gonna finish my frame modifications, weld in my braces and brackets for the four link so that don't tear off again. And then I'm gonna buy a turbo and a pinion gear, or maybe a rear locker. I like the electric locker idea, so it's streetable, but that's still happening. It'll still be out this summer, it'll just be a little later. I'm not buying property this year, probably next, and we're gonna play with this. Right, Boo? She's freaking awesome. I love that she puts up with me. Pretty cool. But, yep. There we go. Well, these guys are digging into stuff.
Dude, what a fucking mess.
What's going on, Ev?
Whoever the fuck touched this car should die. What is this shit?
I'm never gonna have a radio.
Oh my god, I don't know. Going Amish.
I'll let them keep going. But I'm gonna look into my fuse box here. All the front end stuff's tight, so it's gotta be just alignment. I'm gonna put these wheels over here on. These stocks. Just on the front till I can get tires for these again. I like these wheels a lot better. Fit a lot better. But yeah. Peel them on, or put them on real quick. See what we get. All right, so I'm pulling this fuse, which is a three-part fuse. This is the ignition and then both ABS fuses. I'm gonna pull this fuse and then I'm gonna pull the fuse box, find out which two leads go to this at a 12 volt positive, and then put them on a switch if possible. If not, I'll figure out a different trick just to run this fuse and put these on a switch. But that's what I'm doing as of right now. This fuse is fighting me! This car don't want to cooperate ever. Alright, so there's a single lead to that. And no lead to that one, that's odd. Man. Well, we'll figure it out. But that's it for right now. He's trying to find this one little squeak in my audio system. How's it going?
Shitty.
Apparently my car's gutted now. That's okay though. I welded his diff, so he's helping me out. He's a good friend. Right, Ripstick?
That is right.
And I'm getting food.
Yeah.
So it's a win-win.
Win-win. And I got this part like I wanted to. Got the casing off of it. And it seems that that fuse, that's ignition, has these two that are ignition and then this one that's ABS. And it seems that this wire is the only one going to that pin. So if I put this on a switch, it should be deactivated inside the cab. I'm going to test that theory though, prior to snipping it. So, all right. Evan's gonna keep working on this. He's getting someplace. I found the wire and how I want to run it. Go get wire connectors and a couple of switches. So we're making a pit stop and running uptown with Eric. And a yeep. And a yeep yeep. Here we go. Alright, so I'm back. I got a little goodie bag of stuff. Wire and harnesses and stuff, so I'm gonna snip this and then run some leads off of it into the cabin to a toggle switch. And Evan here is actually, I think Ripstick is ripping some nonsensical ass wires out of the place. What is that?
Some customs.
What is that? Junk. There's a whole extension cord in here.
It is. It's like trailer wiring, I swear to God.
Like, for real?
Junk.
What was it ran to? All this box of stuff over here?
Yeah. 12 million different amps. And
where is it? Right here? Oh, yeah. And there's more in there?
Well, there's a big chunk of wiring, all the shit near the radio.
So I'll go back to stock speakers, no components
up. Aftermarket speakers, but factory harness.
They are aftermarket speakers? So really good speakers with stock harness.
Yeah, which
and then
have a problem.
That Hurricane amp or whatever it is back to the sub, right?
Hyphonics?
Yeah, that's not Hurricane. Hyphonics?
Yes.
What is that?
Ancient.
Is it old?
Yeah.
1800 watt?
It'll do the job though.
It'll move the. I got a kicker and then that other weird sub, but I need a box.
Just get rid of one of them.
I think I'm gonna build a little box for the back. But yeah, I'm gonna start doing this. Run the wire. We'll see ya in a little bit. Alrighty. I spliced and heat shrunk these two. And he's wiring in a switch, toggle, and I'm gonna snap this back together and put all this back together since I'm done here. All right, well, I am done underneath the hood. Ripstick's got one of the toggle switches ran. He's peeled back my yaw sensor harness there, that orange wire. I'm gonna cut and put leads on that for another toggle switch. That's your 12 volt source to that yaw and G, lateral G sensor, which also pulls your throttle. Like if it trips, it pulls your throttle response. So, Evan, how much lighter is this thing?
I don't know, probably 20 fucking pounds.
Oh, just wire?
All that fucking wiring.
Look at this, we found even more wires. Yeah, I took that wire out too. So, Ripstick's got, I'm gonna snip that and he's gonna run those two things for me. And then I gotta take this up for an alignment. So I gotta switch the other wheel. And Evan's gonna put the whole back end back together and hope that this stupid ass buzzing went away. That's a lot of RCAs and cables and bullshit. Like, hopefully that, well, for quality sound, but if quality sound, little squawky bird in my speaker, it's gonna be annoying. Hope so.
Going along with what was in here.
Okay, so, well, anyway, he's almost done. He snipped that, he's doing that, he's putting the last switch in, right?
Yep.
And that's to the yaw sensor. And I'll heat shrink those, and then we'll put this back together. And it should then, once those are off and the TCD button is, oh man, hold door to the shin. Ow!
See, it wasn't funny to you, it was funny to me.
Oh, did you feel it?
Kind of.
Oh man, sensitive, overly. Anyway.
Anywho.
It should act a lot more like a 240. There will be a bunch of dash lights on, but then when I'm driving, I can turn it back off and.
That's why they make black tape. That's what my truck has.
Over the check engine light? Every time I check, it's still under the hood, so I don't know why they keep telling me to look for it.
Yeah, they're just wrong.
Just wrong. Evan's got to put the... He's got it dumbed down to a sub and stock speakers now.
Oh, yeah.
But he's got to electrical tape all of the radio to adapter for these back in.
So you get a nicer...
But I'm going to get a new radio because I don't really like this Pioneer thing. It's like overly cheap, so.
So we bought some heat shrink and nice buck connectors.
Oh, I will when I do it that way. Yeah, for sure.
But
yeah, should act a lot better on the street. But all right, we'll get back to you when it's back together. I gotta take this up to the alignment rack pretty soon. Well, Ripstick's gonna drill one more hole for the switch, and then that's done. We'll put the center console back together. Evan's up there doing that. I'm gonna swap this front tire to the stocks as soon as he's done drilling, because I gotta put the jack right there. This car is dumb. It's frustrating. But anyway, should be cool. Well, so he got the center console back in,
right? Switches are in.
The fun switches are in.
And they work.
Evan kind of screwed us up here, because when we originally tested this white box controls the cluster, and I was very confused as why adding a little bit of wire ruined everything.
Hey,
but he figured it out, and now it should work. So we're gonna put it back together and take it for an alignment. Evan messed up my radio completely.
No.
It don't work at all.
It's worse than what it was.
That's all right. We'll get it to work someday. But everything else should do what it's supposed to do now. So take it for an alignment. Hopefully the tire issue's fixed. I'll buy two tires for the other wheels. And then probably two tires for these wheels, because they'll be gone as soon as, now that the fun buttons work. But yeah, so 350Z, I'm gonna take it up for alignment, and then I'll get back to you. All right, so we're at the shop here, and my cousin Zach is going to do my alignment, and I'm pretty excited. He's pretty excited. But yeah, we'll see how far out it is real quick.
On the fucking...
I'm doing a little steering stuff, and then we'll see how far... It said a large adjustment's required, so we'll see how far out of whack she is. I'm guessing it's pigeon-toed real bad. Well then, that's a little out. Is that 9.5 degrees pigeoned in?
Yeah, that's your, it should be your caster. Okay, so that's your wheel up like this. So your rear toe is actually in. So we could adjust that. And then this is way the fuck off. Your fucking tires are like this. And then, oh. And your camber's off. So, with an alignment, you have to do caster and camber first before you can adjust toe. So these adjustments are gonna be way worse after we're done with this.
So it's clapped?
Yeah.
Sweet. Do you think you can handle it?
Oh, I fix it right up good.
Okay, thank you. Everything... Well, Zach got it fixed, so... You good?
It's fast.
But anyway, fixed though, right?
Very good.
Okay, very good, very good. Nice. I give lady money, I go slide sideways now. Goodbye. So, alignment's fixed. Two of the toggle switches, they both work and do what I wanted to. Unfortunately, some of these cars also have a brake switch that cuts throttle. This one unfortunately has it as well. So I'm gonna figure out how to bypass that and still have brake lights. And we'll do that in the next video, and then I should be good. I can left foot brake while staying in the throttle, do standing burnouts and drifting. Then I'll just have to weld the diff and we'll be good. But that's it for today. Thanks for coming back to the channel and seeing the new things. Appreciate your support, and we'll see you in the next one.